going to talk about our first day in metal casting, putting on the protective equipment and pouring metal. So we put our face covering and safety glasses on. I'm wearing long pants and closed-toed shoes. Both are required for working in the casting lab. We're going to be pouring metal, so we're going to go ahead and put on a protective coat. This coat has Velcro for securing. Others have snaps, depending upon which one you grab. Then we're going to grab an apron. This particular apron has straps that go over your head and your arms go through, and then the loose straps will tie in the back. Others have a clip type securing mechanism. Now we're going to grab leather gloves. Be a pile of left and a pile of right gloves, all the same size, then the shoe covers. So now I'm going to put the shoe covers on wearing gloves so that we don't have to disinfect the shoe covers. So one size fits all with the shoe covers. Velcro flaps in the back for securing. Now we're ready for the helmet face shield. So this has been disinfected for you and just in the back. Now we're ready to go and pour our molds. These are permanent Mustang molds, and we're going to put a permanent cope on them. The cope has holes for the metal to pass through. You're going to want to put the small holes down. And a little bit of talc on the bottom of the cope. And then you'll assemble a second mold. You're going to pour two. Now when you're getting ready to pour, hold the transfer ladle handle horizontally, and then bring that ladle right up close to where the metal comes out of the spigot in the furnace. Come down with it and back up with it so we minimize the amount of drop, the distance that the metal drops, to minimize splashing. Now when you're ready to pour, you're going to pour fairly quickly. Don't over pour over the top of those rings. And if you've moved along quickly, metal's still going to be hot enough to pour a second one similar. Returning the excess metal to the furnace, be real careful. You want to avoid splashing. And then return your ladle to the dump box right there for the next person. After pouring, you're done with your helmet. And we will disinfect that later in the video.
Okay, our instructor has told us that the metal is cooled enough to break out, so I'm going to start by removing the brass rings with the spatula. Everything is very hot, so I'm going to use pliers. It's not the only way, but one way to remove the brass rings is to remove them with the pliers. And then we're going to grab the tongs. Going to go over and cool this off.
You may need to tap the mold with a tool to remove it from the casting. You can see it took a couple of times to shorten the video. We just went ahead and I'm bringing it over to the water tank, and I'm gonna swirl it around for a moment, maybe 5 seconds or something like that. I'm agitating it to transfer the heat. Then I'm going to place it over in a little holding fixture that we have. So the cope and the sprue, are still attached, and so we're going to remove those by holding the cope with pliers and then striking with a hammer, and that will pretty quickly remove it. I'm making sure anything I touch, any that's been hot recently, I want to double check it carefully.
Take it
touching
over to the sanders. And this little area of the gating system that's been broken off but is kind of rough needs to be smoothed down with the sanders.
There's an on-off switch on the sander, and then using light pressure when we are removing those gate stubs from the back of the casting. Just want to smooth it down a little bit. You don't need to sand too much on this. Since we have limited amount of tools and social distancing, make it okay, and then you'll have your
for your liking. and we're finished with our Mustang horse head.
You can remove your protective equipment immediately after casting if you like. In the video, I kept it on just because I was kind of trying to get the video done. So you could take this all off. I've removed the shoe covers with gloves on. Then I'm going to take those gloves that I've worn, and they're going to be set aside, not back on the pile. So that was a little hiccup in the video. So then your equipment is going to be actually sanitized. So we'll set it aside to make sure that it goes to the to be sanitized pile and remove everything. So with safety glasses on, you really can go and finish your casting. As I showed in the video, I was wearing the equipment, but you can take that off sooner. Now, very important, we only have a couple of helmet shields, and so you're going to want to desanitize for the next person right away after you're done casting. So while you're casting is cooling, perhaps you can go ahead and do this operation. So we've sprayed down paper towel with the IPA, and then wiping down all the inside surfaces, the adjustment band there that gets in contact with your head, that should be wiped down for safety for the next person. I'm wiping down the inside of the shield just to be safe, and then other areas that I've touched. Remember, I wiped down my hands with the IPA, so I should be safe to do this cleaning operation. We're doing our best here to keep everyone safe, and with your participation, it'll be great.